Well, hello there, and welcome to IWD's Pure Warfare Pay-Per-View. This is show 30, 40 even. I almost said 30, it's 40! I'm IVATOPIA, I'm alongside...
Tyler Steele.
As Happy Man is making his entrance for the opening match. As we know, this is going to be an I Quit match with Gary. His Extreme Championship's on the line. What's your thoughts on this match? Do you think he's going to be able to pull it off? He's tapped out 3 times in non-official matches recently.
Well, the opponent he's going against is a very scary opponent, as you mentioned just a minute ago, that he's made him tap more than once and has embarrassed him in front of all his fans. Well, I don't know if that's going to decrease his chances of winning, if it's going to play with his mind, but he's going to need to keep his head straight if he wants to keep the title.
Definitely. Have you seen the ring as well? Pure Warfare on it.
It's very nice.
IVATOPIA's got Pro Wrestling X and stuff at the bottom.
Our team did a very good job.
Definitely, definitely. And obviously, of course, now we're going to have Gary coming out. So how do you think this match is going to go?
Well, I think that it's going to go one way, or it's going to be both of them fighting to the end, to the death, for the championship. Gary, you don't want to underestimate him, because he's got many mind games, taking you outside, hitting you out there, using those weapons. You have to do what you have to think before you do. He's very unpredictable.
Definitely, I agree with that, and I got a fact for you. Up until tonight, the guy who's had the most main events at pay-per-views has been Gary. He's had 4 to 5, depending if you count the time TJ Eclipse took the belt off him and had an extra match. But tonight, that will be tied with Ivan and TJ Eclipse as we go to the opening of the show right now. Well, hello there, and welcome to IVATOPIA'S Wrestling Domination. This is Chronic Pain Show, your warfare pay-per-view. The game is Pro Wrestling X, currently in early access on Steam, where you can buy it, as you can see from the link on the screen. Me, IVATOPIA, and my cousin, who's going to be helping out with this, have nothing to do with the game other than buying it and playing it and enjoying it. And I'd also like to add, the opening music you can hear right now is from the title screen of the Pro Wrestling X game itself. Hope you enjoy the show. You know, tonight's Happy Man vs. Gary, they're all in the ring for the IWD's Extreme Championship belt. After that, we've got this amazing match, Striker vs. Pitbull, finally to end this feud and be the new number one contender for next week. Sorry, not next week, next month's pay-per-view. Then we have a 6-man elimination match for the new number one contender for the IWD Extreme Championship next pay-per-view. And after that, these are the opponents, of course. And after that, we have got the grudge match with Sir Dave and Grimhold. And finally, tonight, the main event, the IWD World Championship, is on the line. Ivan Reaver taking on Bryce, taking on Crusher, taking on TJ Eclipse. Let's get back to the main match now. What do you think of the card tonight?
Well, we have 6 amazing matches. And I know the 2 that we'll be focused on the most, or the 3, is this match, the main event for the World, IWD World Championship, and then the title shot. I mean, it's pretty exciting here tonight.
Yeah, and it's 5 matches, but we had 2 pitches up for because there's been 6 in one match. As we go to listen to Gary in the back.
Today you will suffer like no one ever was. I will make sure of it.
Back for a pre-recorded message from Gary. See that the move Happy Man tried? Gary stepped aside and smashed him in the head with a kendo stick after we literally just listened to him say, "You will suffer like no one ever was." What's your thoughts on that?
Well, he definitely meaned it, and as you can see right here, he's taking the momentum
concrete
of the mash and slamming his face outside of the ring.
Okay, on the concrete. Happy Man trying to get away. Oh, his ankle smacked the side of the security rail on the way down then. This is not looking good for Happy Man. So far, he tried to pull up, but it wasn't enough. So far, I think he saw Gary, the Extreme Champion's in trouble.
Ooh, face shot. He's cut open.
And his head hit the steel rail on the way down too. Oh, he went for a low body, got missed, he got hit in the side. As we go to the back, let's do another pre-recorded message from Happy Man before the match.
I don't care if I've been quitting in non-title, not even matches, 3 times in a row. It makes no difference because the belt stays around Happy Man's waist. And tonight, when it's official I Quit match, the only person quitting will, of course, be Gary. The insane one, not me, because I'm a happy man. It'll be happy days for us all, people. Unless you're a Gary supporter, and of course, it's going to be a very sad, sad day for you.
Whoa! Gary just slammed Happy Man in the air across his knee. What's your thoughts on what Happy had to say early in the night?
Well, he's saying that the belt's going to stay around his waist and that Gary's not going to have any chance, any opportunity to take it off of him.
But so far, the match has been all Gary would say. You know, Happy Man is trying to use some of the sneaky tactics now to get his hand on the kendo stick. Oh!
This could be the turning point in the match for him. But Gary, I don't believe he's ever tapped out in anything so far. So do you believe he's going to tap out tonight? Or is Happy Man about to lose the title? Before we go to the back to listen to Pitbull.
Well, there's a big chance, and I know that he wants his revenge.
Ooh. Oh, I think he shoved his knee into his head on the way down then. That was an amazing variation of the RKO. As we go to the back, oh, Dragon Suplex.
So today, I'll finally be able to lay the smack down on that wife-beating scumbag striker, yet you all boo me and not him. That's how pathetic you are. I thought you were my crew. You're not my crew. You are nothing but scumbags who hold me back, and tonight I will destroy him, win a normal tender match, then I go on defeat. I don't care who it is, TJ, Clips, Ivan, whoever. I will beat them, and only the true crew members will back me. So shut your mouths, people.
Wow, very emotionally aggressive by Pitbull. What's your thoughts on what you had to say for that?
The rivalry between him and Stryker are heating up. Ooh, is a big move. It's thrown around in the ring.
Definitely. Because like I said, Pitbull's basically, this should be the end of the feud, hopefully. They both agreed after this match to go separate ways. And the winner will get a number one contender match against, like, the winner tonight. Is it going to be TJ Clips? Is it going to be Ivan? Is it going to be Crusher? Or the underdog and the one who's, you know, right out there, Bryce, the best. What's your thoughts on that before we go to back and listen to you, though?
Well, we're going to see if Bryce can live up to his name.
Definitely.
Theodore, I should be in the main event for the world championship. No, I'm in a stupid six-man elimination match. Rubbish. That is right. But Extreme Championship, if I win, I get a shot at that. You know what, Sir Dave? You disrespect me so much. Not only will I win this and prove you wrong in every way possible. That's right. And how much you've got it out for me. I'll then go on to the next pay-per-view and beat whoever the Extreme Champion happens to be. Because I am Theodore. So cheer for me. Stop. Why are you booing? Stop booing. Stop booing me.
Theodore is not happy as Happy Man lays Gary out. Which he falls on what Theodore had to say.
Well, those are some fighting, stinging words from him. We're going to see if he can put those words into action here in his match tonight.
He feels disrespected and feels he should not be put in Extreme Championship match opportunity. But he said he's going to win it anyway and beat whoever. Basically the winner of these two, the next pay-per-view, and win the belt. He said he should be in the main event for the world title. What's your thoughts on that? Do you agree with him there, or is Sir Dave making the right call? And why is Gary pinning him?
One,
he's counting for some reason. What are you doing?
Three.
What, he pinned him. What? It's an I Quit match. What's going on?
Game over.
Falls count anywhere?
It's I Quit. He's got to quit. What happened then?
Obviously, he gave up if they rang the bell or he tricked the system.
He's running and Gary's going. So what's Gary doing? Okay, Happy Man is running to the back and what? Gary's just walking off. What's he? No, he's getting a kendo stick. He's grabbed a kendo stick. We go to the replays now. We need to get a call on this. It's better be an I Quit match. What is going on? You want to talk through the replays?
Well, it was a great match, but a very confusing ending, as we were saying that it's an I Quit match. He went for a pin for a three, but that wasn't the rules of this match.
Yeah, so is he still the shooting champion? It's Gary.
I guess we have to figure out. We have the commissioner here tonight. He'll make the decision.
Hopefully, because the referee messed up big time then. You don't count for an I Quit match. Just say it. Even I know that. I'm an announcer. I like this thing. Gary, I think he was embarrassing him. He's walking over to get a kendo stick and Happy Man's hightailing out the building. Look at him. He's running. And look, he's just slowly walking over. Oh, but we've gone to the back to hear something.
Now. Dave, in the house, people. What the fudge? Where are you running to? I know you just pinned, but it's I Quit match. The match is still on. That's right. The match is still officially on. Okay, somebody get him back in the ring. Okay, apparently he's left the building. Okay. Okay, the match is still on. Someone get him back in the ring later on, and this match continues. It's not over. His belt is still on the line. But I do want to announce today, the next match is going to be Stryker, of course, versus Pitbull. And I want this, since it's going to be the last match they ever have together, as official, to end this feud of theirs. They may face in the future, granted, you know, when they're past cross, but they won't go in directly for each other. For that, I want this to go off with a bang. That's why I specifically made, I didn't want to say anything on that Chronic Pain, because I wanted to make sure it got here. But if you look above the ring, there's a steel cage, 15 feet steel cage. That is right. Tonight, the first ever time in IWD's history, will be a 15 foot steel cage for Pitbull versus Stryker for the normal tender match. Now get the match on, people.
Oh, did you hear that? We're having a steel cage match for the first one in IWD's history for this match, Stryker vs Pitbull. A cage match for this normal contender match. And not only that, Happy Man's left the building, but his I Quit match is still officially on. What's your thoughts on that? A Stryker makes his entrance, a showstopper himself.
Well, this, as you said, is the first steel cage match, and this is going to be exciting. this is going to go down in history. And I do agree with the match. It was not the rules, not the stipulations. So for them to come back and continue the match is a great decision by the commissioner.
They just got your hands unhappy because apparently he left. He thought it was over. He ran out the building.
He looked very upset.
Yeah.
Crying and running like a baby.
And bleeding all over the place. And I believe I've got word that Gary's apparently chasing after him. He's also left the building. So I don't know what's going on. Look at that cage. That looks beautiful. Them blue bars. Look, is that impressive? Wow. What's your thoughts on the cage and this stipulation and this match itself?
Well, it's a very amazing structure that these two will be fighting in. Once the cage drops down, they will be locked in with each other and hell is going to break loose.
Definitely. And what's your thoughts on that? This war? Will this be the day Shaggy finally pins climbs out of the cage? Basically beats Pitbull. So far, he has not been able to get a single win on him.
The only way that I see this rivalry ending is if one severely hurts the other and shows respect at the end of the match. But I don't see that happening. But if it does, I think that's the only way this would end on a good note.
Definitely. But at the same time, Stryker gave his word after this match he will walk away. And Pitbull agreed too. But Pitbull also stated that he's going to make sure he ends his career tonight by injuring him. So, and yeah, the winner will go on for the World Championship. Let's see if he will stick to it.
The days, the hours that these two have wrestled each other leads up to this moment. Here at Pure Warfare for the first ever steel cage match.
And how the people's... as the fight begins, how it's changed with these two. Everyone thought Stryker couldn't get the job done. Now they're willing him to beat him. Oh, what a beautiful drop to start off with. What do you think of this blue cage?
It's very amazing, but I can tell you right now, to be swung into it, that is going to hurt. And I can tell you right now, that's going to happen.
Definitely. Oh, RKO!
This match is dangerous just with these two in a ring, but a steel cage that heightens... The heightens everything.
Definitely. As he goes at the top, what's he gonna do? Clothesline!
Ooh, what a nice, terrific move from top rope.
The crowd's firmly behind Stryker in this match.
Stryker's showing off his abilities here.
Ooh, nice arm drag by the pit bull himself.
Great counter.
Where's he going? I don't think he's really getting up. He's trying to leave. Stryker tried to grab him, he missed. He's trying to get him. He caught him! Whoa! See that, the force of that!
Oh my gosh, he dropped on his neck!
Oh! Did he miss? I think he missed his line shot though! Wow, that was impressive!
That was an amazing move. Pitbull has got to be hurting.
The height he got on that was incredible! He wasn't even a quarter way up the cage!
No, fell straight on his back.
Oh, clothesline!
Wow.
I think it's the first time we've seen a clothesline in our company. And Strikers, the first cage match, first clothesline!
He's climbing up now.
Oh, he's making a big run! Stryker making a big run!
Pitbull's got it.
Oh! Fudge!
Look at his arm, it looks like it's broke.
Oh, Stryker's heart getting back onto his feet and he's getting caught in a brain buster.
Now he's lifting him up and he's looking for
a brain buster. Yes, a brain buster, I thought it was.
Focusing on that neck region.
Speaking of Stryker, we had a pre-recorded message from early in the night. We're going to go to that in a minute after we see this amazing... double arm backbreaker. Let's go to Stryker once more. Today, I step into, for the first time ever after Sir Dave announced it, a cage match. I make history in IWD today, with Pitbull as we enter this cage. I've already seen it looking out there, it looks massive. I wonder what it was this morning when I arrived. I did not realise it was actually for a match for us. You know, I'm going to go in there, I'm going to do my best, and I'm going to destroy Pitbull. I'm going to come to number one tender, and I'm going to steal this show and prove why I'm a showstopper. That is right, because I'm Stryker, the showstopper. Being the showstopper, he just almost stole the show. He knocked Pitbull almost from the top. That was vicious, and Pitbull's horse back on his feet. I think Stryker was going to go for then, and he couldn't believe Pitbull was up again. What an incredible move that was. Do you see the height? And yet he's still getting up. Oh! He shoved his knees into his face with that lion stone.
Let's make sure he stays down.
And Pitbull is refusing!
Oh, missed a shot there. Uh-oh, he's swinging him under the ropes.
What's he gonna do now?
Uh-oh, drop kick!
Oh, that was more his knees into his face than the actual drop kick. A little bit sloppy, but looked like I got more impact. That was impressive.
Now he's whipping him into the corner, looking for something big here.
Oh, just a couple of
shots to the face. Uh-oh, snake eyes. He could hit his face on the bars.
Oh, he's going for a sharpshooter.
Can he make him tap here? Will you humiliate him in front of all these people?
That is the thing. We know to climb out to victory. Can you pin or make submissions the first one we've ever had? Will they allow that? If he taps out, will the match be over?
Well,
or is it just climb out only?
This is our first, but usually you can pin or make him tap.
But I've seen some in some companies where they didn't allow it in the past. And in other ones when, like you said, guess we'll find out if the ref calls it. If someone goes for a pin, we'll definitely see. If someone taps, I think it's called.
Nice kick to the chest. He's trying to cave
in. Oh, yeah. He's getting that extra momentum from running in and smashing his foot now.
Top rope again.
Stomping the mud hole in him.
Oh, I think he bruised his ribs with that.
Oh, wow. Pitbull got hit and got up.
Someone's been doing their core exercises.
Yes, Striker didn't see that. He got up, but he got caught from behind. He did not expect Pitbull to be back on his feet after that amazing moonsault.
Uh-oh, payback here.
Snake out of his own.
Oh. Wow. Drops to the mat.
What's he going to do?
Striker's getting back up here.
He's got him. Uh-oh.
It's too late. Another
suplex.
Brainbuster.
Oh, he has a brainbuster. You're right. See him grab his feet. That really was painful on him. But he got to his feet first.
These two are showing their heart and their dominance.
Definitely. What's he going for? Oh, another line salt. Oh, his knee slammed into his face then. That's like a, wow, a flat one. What's he going to do now? Oh, I think he's going to leave. Striker could win it right here and be number one contender. What's your thoughts? Pitbull doesn't do something, he's won it.
Uh-oh. It looks like it's too late. Yep, he's already at
no,
the top.
No! Yes!
He shook the fence!
No!
Oh,
no!
My gosh!
He's coming dead! I think he's dead! He's dead!
He shook the fence and he flew off.
At the last second!
Oh, what a nasty drop.
How did he get up?
What?
That is incredible!
Oh, my gosh.
See, he's like, bring it! Bring it! See that to him!
Uh-oh. He's realizing how dangerous Striker is.
He's trying to get out. I don't think he's able to strike him back to his feet. Oh, he's getting one of his own. Oh, and he hit him on the way down. That was a nut shot on the way down. That was a nut shot on the way down, people. Oh, and he's stomping him to make sure he stays down. Wow. What a match has been so far. These two put everything in there. These two could both be injured after this match. Oh, look at this. Oh, what a backbreaker. I think Striker's making sure Pitbull stays down, because after that fall, you think he would, but after Striker's fall, you think Striker would, and Pitbull went for the... And now he's in trouble because of it. I believe Striker's got to do this, because Pitbull's shown he's got the same heart as Striker. What's he doing now? Oh, he's pounding him some. Pitbull is in trouble. This is all Striker. That massive fall. It's been all Striker. Uh-oh. I think it's over. He's going to climb out and win. What's your thoughts? Can Pitbull get out from this?
I don't know. He's getting to the top again. He's got to get to the other side, because if he doesn't, he's going to shake that fence.
Definitely.
He's going to take another nasty
New number one contender. He's won it. He's won it. He's up to his feet. He's won. Oh, no! Holy
oh,
fudge!
Oh, gosh. His legs.
Fudge!
He's crippled.
Did you see that? That was incredible. That's it. How is he getting to his feet?
This guy is not human.
Wow.
Oh!
That was like, you know, like a, you know, like a 10, 15 foot powerbomb by someone. That was incredible. That was like two Grimholds are standing on each other's shoulders, powerbombing someone down. The force of that and the height he got.
These guys are going to kill each other.
Seems like, oh! What a clothesline! He's bleeding, people! Wow. This could be it. I think he thinks he's not over. Is he trying to injure him? Is he trying to put him down? But then again, the guy's gone out a ridiculous amount so far, so maybe he's just trying to put him down so he can get out and win.
Nice scoop slam.
Did he do it? I think he's going for it. He's won. There's no way he's getting up from that, surely.
He might, though. Striker's taking some nasty falls, but he's still got up.
But Pitbull, I think, he's taken more nastier since. It's over. Striker's climb out. He's won it. You've done it. Striker's won. What? He's not! Oh my!
God.
Oh! He hit him too! Oh! That did more damage to him than Pitbull, I think!
That was amazing!
No offense, I'm right, saying it right here and now, that is the move of the night! I don't see anything topping that.
That's
after that!
That's the move of the year!
Yeah, nothing's topping that! Striker, get climbed! You've won! Go for it!
Oh my god!
No! He's trying to get up! And Pitbull did! He blocked the clothesline! Oh! How did you stand it after that? How are they standing?
Looking for a nice rebound off the ropes. RKO!
KO. But I believe, was that a mistake though? He could have climbed out and won. But he went for that amazing move instead. He's truly, he's a showstopper. He's trying to steal the show. Had he made a mistake doing that? Oh! To me, that was an opportunity. Could he have climbed out then? I think he could have if he didn't go for that jump. Well, it looks like he's going to win anyway. I thought he's trying to get up. And Pitbull's staying down. I think he's won it. Unless he's going for another moonsault. Oh, no, he doesn't realise it. Pitbull's up. He doesn't see it. He doesn't see Pitbull! Oh my! Oh! Is he even breathing after that shot? Okay, he's pinning. Will the ref count it? One, yes, the ref will count
two,
it!
Two.
What a kick! Oh my! How? How did he kick? How? How, Tyler Steele?
He's got up first, too.
How did he kick out?
I have no idea.
He seemed a bit confused, and he picked him up, and he like looked to the fans. And I guess he's like, do you want me to do something? And he said, yeah. Oh! Nice drop kick. How's this match going to end with these two? This is ridiculous. What you've got so far on this first ever cage match in IWD's history?
This is the best wrestling match I've ever seen in past companies and in this company. What a match.
Definitely. And we got the Showstopper, who actually, a debut of Chronic Pain, was the opening match. So if it's day one, this guy's been doing five-star matches. Okay, is he finally going to win? Or is he going for a moonsault? Or is Pitbull going to break it up again? I think he's done it. He's climbing, isn't he? No, he's going for a moonsault! He climbed a moonsault!
Holy! Oh my gosh!
It's over! There's no way he's getting up from that! No way!
One.
I want him to, though! Come
two,
on, kick out, Striker! Please kick
three,
out!
Three.
Pitbull's won! I don't like Pitbull at the moment, but give all the credit in the world!
He made him slip!
Yeah, he was going for a second moonsault. Do you see that? He was about to jump, and he caught him in the last second.
He made a mistake. He was showing off a little too much, and it cost him this match. But great match by both of them.
Yeah, look at this replay. Tell us what happened here.
This is the first ever moonsault from the steel cage,
wow. And
that was amazing. As you can see, Stryker's taking a lot of damage from his moves and showing all of his abilities. Stryker may have lost, but he definitely showed us what he was made of as he smacks the mat.
Some of these falls were ridiculous. I think this was the first time he kicked out, wasn't it? For some miracle, I don't know how he did, but he kicked out of that. He kicked out of that point. That showed it. And look, this is where he got caught. He was mid moonsault. And just before his feet left, he shook the cage, slammed into it with everything he had. His whole career, people depending on that move. And he got there just in time. And that's all she wrote. Stryker's got nothing to be ashamed after that match. Nothing, but at the end of the day, Pitbull once again, another win on his belt over Stryker. As we go to the first ever for a six-man elimination match for the new number one contender in IWD Extreme Championship at next pay-per-view. Basically, we're starting off with two people in the ring for 5 minutes. After that, every 2 minutes, someone else will come out. You'll be pinfall and submissions. What's your thoughts of that? And apparently number one is the Star. Who do you think's, obviously he's going to have him and number two guy going to have the, disadvantage. What's your thoughts on this match and who do you think can pull this off?
Well, I think this is going to be another amazing match because as you said, this is also the first new rules in a new match type. So that's really exciting. I don't think I could give it to anyone right now, but I do think the Star has a true chance to shine, which could give him a great career opportunity.
Definitely. So far, he's had two matches, one against Stryker, lost, one against Ivan, lost, but he came so close to beating both of them. Will this be his night? In a month from now, he could become the new Extreme Champion, taking on either Happy Man or Gary, because that match is still ongoing, so we don't even know who the opponent's going to be next month yet. Oh, number two is Theodore! He's not going to like that. Remember, people, these were randomly picked. But Theodore won't see it that way in his eyes, it'll be, so they made sure I come out number two so I don't have a chance. You know the way he whines. But at the same time, you can't take away his ability. He is one of the top superstars. He's gone, like, the last couple two pay-per-views, hasn't taken on TJ Clips back and forth, and he's had some incredible matches with TJ. Even the last Chronic Pain, the main event, him and TJ, once again, was a five-star match. And he was so close to winning. And the night before that, he technically lost TJ the title. But Sir Dave, when he saw the replay, said, I ain't accepting that. Restart the match, and he got caught, and TJ kept his belt. So already, since he's been back, he's already had an impact on TJ, as this match is underway. What's your thoughts on who's going to get the advantage in these two? We got the veteran in there. Oh, former world champion. And the new guy, the Star, who's only had two matches against two veterans. One we just saw, Stryker. Obviously, he's already lost. But he did defeat this guy, and of course Ivan is in the main event. What's your thought?
Well, looking at these two, we can hardly give the win to somebody, but as I said, underestimating your opponent could cost you the match. The Star, bursting out on the scene not that long ago, going against a former world heavyweight champion. This is going to be very good. Skill-wise, Theodore has got this in the bag.
But again, it's four more people come out after this. Oh, what's this in the back? Oh, did Gary and Happy Man, he's in the match. They must be back in the arena. What's your thoughts on this? I guess Gary caught up to Happy Man.
Well, the match has not ended. As you can see, a spear on the stage.
He's pinning him now.
One, two.
What are you doing?
Three.
I guess two rounds for fair play. Still an I Quit match, people. Still an I Quit match. The match isn't over. And he's celebrating. The match is not over still, though.
All they're doing is one-upping each other.
Definitely. Back to the actual match itself, the other match, the star is taken to TJ. Sorry, not TJ, Theodore. Sorry, I'm getting our world chat mixed up with Theodore now. Look, he's bleeding all over the place. You know, he has 5 minutes. If he can pin the guy, he's going to have an advantage. He wouldn't have been tired for the next guy coming in. You know, he can focus on him. If he doesn't, the next guy could completely throw this out of there. The next guy comes in, he could help Theodore, he could help Star. Could be a true triple threat. We don't know. Ooh, is he going to make him tap? Like he tried to do to TJ, and that's why he really lost his match. Speaking of the Star, we're going to the back to listen to a pre-recorded of what he had to say.
Star is here. He's rising above you all. Why is he above you all? Because he is the Star. The Star is here. Remember that, people. The Star. You're looking at greatness. Ting Bang Wang. The Star is here.
Oh, we caught him out of nowhere. What's your thoughts on what the Star had to say early in the night? Is he living up to what he had to say?
Well, his attitude seems great, but he's got to put it into this match to show everybody he really meant what he said.
Oh, he shoulder barged him then. He went for like a left thing, but it's more just right shoulder smashed him in the face. That was impressive, a lion soak by him. And you see, the force of it caused the two kendos to bounce, and I think one hit the Theodore in the face. As he power bombs him on it! And he's on his chest, it bounced so high! This could be it, Theodore could be out! One! Two! Oh, so close! He almost pinned the former world champion right there and then. That would be a big win, even if he loses the rest of the match. He's got a kendo, what's he doing? Oh, he's going high! The Star is about to fly! No, he's not!
Teased him a little bit there.
I don't think he expected Theodore to get to his feet so quick.
Oh. He's going up for a drop kick, but he caught him. Now he's in the corner, dangerous place.
Oh, and we go to the back now to listen to Tiger.
Oh.
Tonight, Tiger's claws come out, and I will destroy everyone in my way. I will prove myself tonight that I do have fangs. I will take a bite out of everyone in that ring that's stupid enough to get in my way.
What's your thoughts? What Tiger had to say just?
Well, Tiger is a beast, and if he really meant what he said here, it's going to be a gruesome match when he gets added to this match, and it is going to be nasty. As you can see, they're already destroying each other, and you can see the Star here right now. He's got a big upper hand, but now he countered.
Definitely, because like I said, he's going to get his fangs out, and he's going to take bites off people if he has to. But what a powerbomb by Theodore!
Smacked his head on the turnbuckles.
Definitely. Oh, low blow! I'm getting word we're getting a phone call coming through, I believe. Let's listen to what this is about. This is a bit weird.
Oh, sorry about that. I dropped the phone. I just smashed that over. Yes, and again. One down over 100 minutes. Oh, how about this one? Oh, yes. Give this one to. Yes, this is great. Oh, you bleed on the floor. What, PPV? What? Oh, yeah. I saw that one coming too. Stop screaming! He's just a happy man! I'm making him a sad man! How about I give him this instead? Oh yes! Oh, this is fun! This is his! What? Where are you going now, happy man? Why are you jumping in that car? You know, I'm gonna fire you to the end of the earth, man!
That was very interesting. Apparently, Gary's called up to Happy Man somewhere and he's smashing stuff over his head, and Happy Man just ran into got into a car and drove off. Oh, we're getting a count now. Must be the next person coming out. 8, 7. Who do you think it's going to be? Pull your bets now. Who's going to be out next?
I give my bets that's going to be Tiger.
Tiger, okay, let's find out. 2. As we see a powerbomb in the ring. 1, and it is Tiger. You were right. You're actually right with something. Here he comes, making his way.
Wow. You're a jerk.
You don't know me right. It was very, very odd days. Oh, he went for a clothesline. He missed. Oh, they went out to meet him. Oh, good stuff, all better of it. Oh, he's making a little hit and run with him. Little running game here. Did he get caught by Tiger? No, he blocked him. as we go to bat to listen to Grasshopper.
Okay, Grasshopper, I'm here to win. I'm a former Extreme Champion. I'm going to prove tonight why I had that belt. Not because the executioners gave me it, because I won it on my own, and I'll do the same tonight. I'll win my match, next pay-per-view, beat Happy Man Gary, whoever happens to be, and prove why I'll be a two-time Extreme Champion, because I am Grasshopper.
And we're back to the match. This is now technically a triple threat for 2 minutes before someone else comes out. What's your thoughts of what Grasshopper had to say? As we see Tia take a vicious powerbomb.
Nasty words by him, and he's saying he's going to eliminate everybody, and he's going to raise his hand high with the victory.
And basically go on to be the Extreme Champion and prove to everyone when he first won it, it wasn't because the executioners, basically. He's going to do it on his own. Oh, who do you think has got the advantage of this match so far, at least three? Tiger's the freshest.
I would say Tiger has the upper hand here, but if he keeps getting slammed like this, he's going to lose that advantage real fast.
Definitely, he's got 2 minutes to eliminate these guys to get ready for the next person. Speaking of which, we have Von Count in the back. Maybe he'll be next person. We do not know. Let's go to Von Count and find out.
Go out there. I'm going to win. You know why? Because I'm Von Count. You can count on that.
I was about to say, find out who's in the back, and obviously he kind of interrupted me. He cut me off. You can count on going to get interrupted by Von Count, but anyway, he said he's going to win. What's your thoughts on that?
Well, I think he definitely has a huge chance. I mean, more people, the more chance of someone winning, anyone winning. I think the chances are equal for every wrestler here.
Look at the strength of the stars! We're about to get another superstar in 6 seconds, or on the timer six. Is it over? Oh, he kicked out. I thought Tiger was going to be out then. Two, one, and who's going to come out now? It is Von Count, and he's making a dash to the ring as we speak. Oh, all three have turned on him. Not except Tiger, he's leaving the ring, the wrong side. I guess he's getting a breather while the other two have gone for him. Just like when Tiger entered earlier, the Star and Theodore both rushed him. Okay, Tiger's making his way over. This doesn't look good. Oh, Theodore's in trouble. Remember, Theodore and the Star started off as one and two. They've been in this the longer. Oh, he went for him, he slipped!
Oh, he just threw him.
I am the Overlord for a reason. I've said it before, the commissionership, when it was around Theodore, I put it on him. TJ Eclipse won his first world championship, because I put it on him. And of course, little Grasshopper's in this very match. Guess who put the Extreme Championship around his waist all them months and months ago? Me. That's right. Only will I win the match tonight, a month from now I'll be the Extreme Champion once again. And not only that, this time I will keep that belt for myself.
Wow, these four are going at it. And what do you think of Overlord basically saying that, you know, TJ won the world belt for the first time because of him. Grasshopper won the Extreme title the first time because of him. Basically, the commissionership was Theodore's because of his, and tonight he's not only going to win, destroy Grasshopper in the process, he's going to actually keep it for himself for once, instead of giving stuff away.
Well, I mean, like you said, he feels like he's just giving everything to everybody, and he's not taking anything for himself.
Wait, what's Von Count doing? Oh, he missed! I thought that was going to be big. I guess it was a big failure. Carry on.
Overlord could be a very dominating champion if he allows himself to take the championship instead of caring about others before himself.
I don't know if he cared about the others more since he was in the group and they would advance his career in the future, and it was like, you know, I help you now, you advance me later. But he never really got advanced because the group kind of imploded on itself. Oh, he's pinning. Is this it? Is the Star going to be out? The Star is gone. But he was in their number one. What's your thoughts on Star losing again? But that was a great match on his part.
Well, the rookie, Star, has nothing to be ashamed of. As you said, he gave it his all, and what an amazing match it was for the time that he was in there.
I believe Von Count basically just gave a little cheer to the Star then. You see how he was waiting while the other two were down? He went, yeah, to the Star as he left. Gave him a little salute of respect. That was nice.
Amazing respect.
As we get in the next guy, who is Grasshopper, so that means the last guy is going to be the Overlord. So he has got the biggest advantage in this. 2 more minutes before he comes out. What's your thoughts on Overlord being the last guy in this match?
Well, that's very dangerous because he will be the freshest. And the thing is, he doesn't even need to be the freshest to win. So a fresh, new Overlord. 1 minute.
Grasshopper's out of nowhere, pinning.
Two. Three.
And he takes Tiger, so he gets in the ring. That is impressive. My Grasshopper.
They all better be waiting and preparing for Overlord, because Overlord is going to go in there and rip their heads off.
Yeah, at the moment, it seems Von Count and Theodore are kind of teaming up against Grasshopper, who's the freshest, what makes sense. And Theodore, like that, slaps him in the back. Oh, what a close at the back of Von Count's head by Grasshopper, making a comeback. I think the fans are firmly behind Grasshopper here. But also Von Count has some fans too. As we go to the back to listen to Sir Dave, I believe.
He's back in the house, your commissioner here. I've got another announcement to make after watching some amazing elimination matches doing brilliantly so far. After seeing such amazing, I have to say amazing again because it was spectacular even, that cage match with Striker and Pitbull. Well done on the pair of you. Pitbull, well done, especially for winning. Striker, again, too bad. But you did it. You gave the fans what they wanted to see, and that was amazing. And because it was so good, you know, we're going to do it again. That's right. Tonight's main event is a four-way. Guess what? It's now a cage match four-way. Yes, for the World Championship. Respect that, people.
Holy mother of a cow! Did you hear that? The main event is now been made into a cage match! A four-way cage match! What's your thoughts on that, Tyler?
So it's very exciting. Our second cage match, and I mean, this is going to be amazing. We're adding more people to it, and just two people alone, really. Oh, wait a minute. One, two.
Oh, he kicked out.
Having two people is really dangerous. I can't imagine what adding more to the equation will do.
And that's a world championship will be on the line still. That's obviously going to involve Crusher, who basically is a beast when he's in the ring. He is insane and vicious. What a powerbomb by Theodore. We've got Ivan, who we know can go. We've got TJ, who's been a great champ. And of course, Bryce. I'm worried about Bryce. What happens if he gets caught in that cage with Crusher? After what happened to them, what, about a month or two ago when they faced each other? No cage! Because he uses speed to advantage as a new Overlord comes out. Here he comes. He uses speed to advantage and he almost won. He won't really be able to use that. He's trapped inside the steel cage. What's your thoughts?
Well, exactly what you said. If he gets caught, that can end his career. As you see, the last cage match, I mean, I don't even know how these guys got up.
Definitely, like, Striker got pinned, and he had to be helped out the arena. We're not sure if he's injured or not. We're hoping he's not. We're hoping the best for him. Pitbull walked out on his own, but he could have been injured, really, just hiding it. Okay, we're down to the final four people. This elimination six-man match now. So, if you had to pick, who would you go with before we go to back and listen to Grimhold?
I'm a big fan of Theodore, but it looks like Theodore is the one that has the biggest advantage here.
Why? Well, how does that work out? He was the number one in there. Number two, sorry.
Been well, there the he's number one, but I know what he's capable of, and everyone else in there knows what he's capable of.
I guess he's the only true real main eventer in there as we go to Grimhold.
Sir Dave, you be getting in my way too much, in my face too much. That's why tonight, as I've seen it's on the cards, so you accepted this match. To me, that made you stupid. Why would you accept a match with me of all people? The guy that people cannot pin unless they've got a weakling to pin. Instead of me, because I'm not the weakling. It's like you going head on with a brick wall. It's like you coming up to a tank and trying to headbutt it to stop it. It's like trying to put your face in front of the cannon as it blows it off. You know what I'm saying? Quite simply, you're gonna pay tonight because it's grim for you tonight, Sir Dave.
Wow, fighting words there. I'll get to that in a second. But as I made a comment that the only true main event in there, Theodore, I would say recent because of course Overlord and Von Count were in the first ever main event for our pay-per-view. First ever pay-per-view Carnage back in, you know, almost 8 months ago now? 7 months ago? And of course Grasshopper was in the second main event against Gary. So they have all main evented before, but Theodore's the one who's probably had the most main events out of these guys. And okay, back to Grimhold. What's your thoughts on what you just had to say?
Saying that just a normal guy trying to go against one of the best, like you said, headbutting a tank. Obviously that's not going to work out very well.
Definitely not. But the thing is, didn't Crusher take Sir Dave to his limit last month? Yes, he beat Sir Dave, but it wasn't as easy as Crusher thought it would be. And I think Grimhold's going to find the same thing when it comes to Sir Dave. He took like 2-3 months on the run, Theodore, and Theodore came out on top once, and then, Sir Dave came out on top at least twice. And I think people underestimate him. He beat our world champion the other week. But because of Theodore's interference, they restarted the match, and that's when he lost. So he is really good. As oh, Grasshopper's kicking out. I was gonna say back there, kick pin. Oh, another pin attempt. This is it. One, two. Ah, so close. He's supposed to do it. What? I'm getting. There's a phone corner back again. One of it's Gary or Happy Man.
You gotta help me. I'm the Happy Man. That Gary's insane. I'm bleeding. My head feels like it's crushed in. He's trying to kill me. He wants me dead. That is right. I found the police! Damon dodged me! Send some help, security from IWD! I'm the extreme champion for a reason! Protect me! Oh, fudge! He's coming back! I've never spoke so fast! Stay away from me! Please stay away! Stay away! Stay away! Ah! Oh, never! Gary's back here! Take this shot to her level! Just give up and it will all be over! Give up! You can't take this shot after shot! Take this one too! I could! No more! Take that! Get out of here quick! What the fudge? You cheap shot me in the car again! I will punch you down! You son of a little happy dude!
Wow, another interesting phone call from Happy Man this time. And he basically, almost had a pin then. He's basically begging us to go and help him. And he said that he's insane, he's trying to kill him. And one thing, did you hear right? He smashed him on his head, told him to give up. And I think I heard Happy Man say, I quit. But I don't think the match is over. I don't think the ref was there at the time. But did he not say, I quit?
He did.
So if that is correct, Gary should now be the extreme champion. I guess we'll have to hear back to see if the ref heard it or not. Oh, we're getting a pin. Two. And Theodore has removed Von Count from the match. Von Count couldn't count on that, could he? And Theodore's like unconscious after it. Look, he's not getting up. He managed to get a pin. Luckily, these two are hammering each other and don't realise. To me, if you pin him now, he's out. Sharpshooter. Look, he's looking at Von Count. He's coming over. Is he going to allow this? Is he going to break it? It makes sense a lot. Oh, he's walking on the back of his head. That is just nasty. What's he doing now? Oh, he grabbing Overlord. And he gave him a vicious nightmare. Von Count's on top of the apron just watching this. Feeling disappointed, I guess. To me, do you think this match went really well for him? Other than losing, of course. I mean, has he got anything to be sorry about?
No, but I can tell you right now, it's going to haunt him that he didn't win.
Definitely. But at the same time, I think it's like the cage match. Basically, no one can really walk away from that looking bad. And again, he was pinned by Theodore. Again, other than TJ Clips, he was the former world champ, the most recent one. So TJ got it off him. Look at this move. Oh, what a dragon sleeper by the Overlord. Talk us through what you think is going on in this match. What's happening now? Who do you think's going to win this now? You went with Theodore before. You still sticking with that?
Yeah, I think Theodore has a big chance. We got to remember the big monster that we have in there.
Who's the freshest, of course. Who apparently can do drop kicks, but basically he missed because as he snapped Mary, he pulled his head down just before he would have took his head off with that amazing drop kick. As he went, oh, was that smart on Overlord's part? Grasshopper went for a Dragon Sleeper. Oh, as he got his head taken off. As I was trying to say, he went for a Dragon Sleeper. What maybe would have caused Theodore to tap, but he broke it up instantly, not allowing the pain or to tap. And then he took Grasshopper's head off. But he did say he would destroy Grasshopper, so it makes sense that he's focusing on him more. And at the end of the day, I forgot. Overlord is still technically part of the former executioners with Theodore. They're still technically in together. Well, of course, Grasshopper's a former member who walked away when they were told to turn on the leader. So we got three former executioners in there, and two of them technically on the same page. Is that what we're seeing here, Tyler?
Well, yeah, I think that's very accurate.
As he's pinning him!
Two.
He tried to sneak a pin on his partner! Wow! Overlord looks annoyed. I think he tried to double cross him. And he couldn't get the pin, and I think Overlord is annoyed. Yep! What's your thoughts on what just happened?
Well, he went after his partner, and his partner did not appreciate that one bit.
I guess in Theodore's defense, I pin him 1, 2, 3, he's out.
Ooh. Nice flip into the ropes.
That was an amazing clothesline. Oh, he missed. Wow. Actually, I don't think he did. Theodore used his strength to hold him there as he smashed him in the head, then he took him down. I thought he missed him, but I think Overlord actually hit him. That's actually a good double team move by the two of them. What's going on now? Clothesline. Oh, no, he missed. And Grasshopper caught him. Grasshopper caught that clothesline. He ducked it and caught him. Wow, this has been a good match so far. What's he going to do now? Oh! Theodore out of nowhere! Brain Busters! Gives him the Brain Buster! Oh, and Overlord's pinned him! This is a good double team move! Two! And with that, he eliminated Grasshopper! Now it's down to these two, so no working together now! No work together. If either of them can get up first, that is. Grasshopper got his feet first, and he's out. Oh no, Overlord! Oh, this is not smart. He's taunting. See that? He's taunting Grasshopper. And Teodoro cut from behind. He's like, I got you. Come on, get in, you little wimp. And then voila, Teodoro advantage from behind. Oh, they're both bleeding. They are both bleeding, people. And Overlord back to his feet. Talk us through what's happening, Tyler.
Well, he just eliminated another wrestler. And now it's just two wrestlers, Teodoro and Overlord. We still got the two eliminations standing at the top of the ramp looking to see who's going to win.
What a clothesline. He almost took his head off with that. How can Teodoro pull this off when he's in there with Overlord if Overlord's focused on him? I think his advantage before was getting a quick pin on him and end it. And unfortunately, Overlord kicked out and he's very annoyed now as he's going for a sharpshooter. Imagine if Teodoro taps out to his partner, Overlord, a guy who should be a bodyguard to him. That ain't going to go down well, is it, with Teodoro's ego?
Well, no, I think tapping in general sucks. And I mean, no one wants to tap out. It's worse than a pin. And
Teodoro, like it said, has had the first ever tap out in the Iron match.
For someone as close as your friend and your partner to make you tap out, I mean, that's going to live with you forever.
And like we said, TJ Eclipse, who used to be best friends with him, made him tap out in the Iron match. Since then, we've seen Happy tap out 3 times in non-official matches, but there's only 2 people who have tapped out in the business so far. Oh, what a brain buster! It busted his head from his brain! And his blood is seeping out! As Overlord is calling to the fans. I think he says one more. Is that what he's going for? Oh! No, Tia does. No, no more! No more! He's got him. He's got it. Oh, he speared him! Into the shuckle. Not the shuttle. The whatever you call that. Rope break. No. What's it called?
Turnbuckle.
That's it! Turnbuckle pad! I'm getting a bit confused. Into the shuttle pad. What a move. Always got him now. That could have been a bad break for Teodoro, though. After that spear, if it wasn't because of the rope break, I think he could have won.
He could have, but that rope was there and it saved him.
He's got such a big, lanky guy. He reached the ropes. Uh-oh, he's got him right where he wants him. What does Teodoro have to do to pull this off in this situation, Tyler?
Well, he's in a bad place right now, and he needs to counter one of these moves and work on his head, because as you can see, his body doesn't take very much damage, but knock off the head of the giant and the rest will fall into place.
Rope break. Lucky for Teodoro. Wouldn't it be better to like chop at his legs? Because then if he's down, you know, what's it, taller they are, the further they fall and all that, maybe that would be a good thing. But then again, with no head, he's basically, everything else is brain dead, isn't it?
You can chop out his legs, you can chop out his head, and then do the other to humiliate him.
Speaking of humiliating, he just did like a DX crotch chop in front of his face. What do you think of that?
That was disrespectful, but it was funny.
And then he dropkicked him in the face after it. Teodoro's face, and he was like, and he got his head taken off. Wow. He's just stomping mud holes into him now. Basically, he's wiping his feet on his back. Oh, he got his own dropkick out of nowhere. The fans are enjoying this match. It's been a match. Oh, he's called for him again. You know, yes, he wants someone else. But oh, and again. Is Overlord getting too cocky here?
Well, he could be.
What's he doing here? Oh, what a clothesline with the run-up as well.
It didn't even look like clothesline. It looked like a straight hammer to the face.
Yeah, because I think he was going for the back of his head. And Teodoro turned around at the last second and like you said, got hammered in the face for it. What would have been worse than what happened to him or getting hit in the back of the head with it? Ow! What's he going for now? Oh, he's calling again. Just pin the guy. Nope. He wants him to tap, I think. He wants him to tap. Gotta give Teodoro credit hanging out in there. Most people, when this is set on, will be, you know, tapping out like a little baby, but Teodoro is hanging in there. The blood. Look at the blood as he calls to the crowd once again. It's dripping down Bon Capetta's face. That blood in the ring is a mixture of almost like 4, 5, 6 guys. I believe Von Count wasn't bleeding earlier, so he's mixing most of the guys in there, but Von Count's. There's definitely a mixture of Teodoro's blood and Overlord. I guess they truly are blood brothers now, after this. What's your thoughts on that as this match continues?
Well, I mean, like you said, it could be a total bloodbath, and it already is, but it looks like they're going to add on to it.
Wow. Oh, in the back! Oh, they're back in the arena! Happy Man's caught Gary. They missed a call up with him. The crowd's loving this. Look, the crowd's going wild for this. Happy Man, Attis has been beating Gary. What's your thoughts? Think he's going to do it? Going to make the guy quit?
I don't know. We're going to have to see if both these opponents are worthy enough of a championship. Who will take it tonight?
Obviously, Happy Man is the longest running stream champion in our history. As we've lost the feed again. We've lost the feed again. I believe Happy Man's making a run for it again for some reason. I guess the run is on it, or the chase even is on again. What do you think of this match? They've basically been fighting since the start of our pay-per-view. We've already seen one full match since then. We almost got another match gone through. And they're still fighting and running from each other. And they've been in the public battling it out. Actually, what is this sign? Is about ethics. Oh! That wasn't very ethical, that low blow. He's got him high. No, he's not. He's got him low. He's giving him a pile driver. Oh, that has really hurt a big guy like that, because you've got all that extra weight coming down in your neck. That's got to really hurt. And Snapmate's working the neck still. Teodor could pull this off now, looking at this. What's your thoughts?
Well, he definitely could. He's lifting the giant up.
Oh!
Slamming him down.
His head hit the turnbuckles on the way down. He's going for the sharpshooter. Is he going to tap? Is he going to tap? I can't see a big man tapping, but look how close to the ropes he is. But he just can't reach it. No, he didn't tap. I didn't think he would. But you never know. And he basically arm dragged him, legs first, into them turnbuckles again and smacking both turnbuckles. He's using the turnbuckles to his advantage as... Oh, this strength of Teodor was impressive to get him so high and drop him in that brainbuster like an accordion. And the guy's up. The guy is up first. This guy is a true monster. This is not good for Teodor. Not one bit. The fans are loving Teodor getting this beaten though. Oh, what an RKO. You love him, you hate Teodor, whatever. You can't deny he is skillful when he needs to be. What's he still heading up for now? Oh, another submission, Dragon Suplex. You think this is going to make him tap?
Well, it could if he gets him cinched in just the right way. He won't stand a chance.
Can he get out of this, though? Or will Over let him out? I think he let him out. He's, like, toying with him. He's like one of them cats toying with, like, a dead mouse. Or, so to say, a live mouse that he can't get away. Uh-oh. What's he going for? A back breaker! That truly will break it back with the back breaker! That was impressive! But overall, his strength is incredible! Oh, what a fist to the face. And he's spitting blood up as he hits him. Oh, he's giving some fists back. He's gone from behind. He's whipped him around. Oh, and he snap made him over. He's on his back. He's grabbed him by the hair. He's risen him to the up. He's got him. He spears him! He took him downtown as he's pinning him. Is that going to be enough? One, as he hooks the leg. Teodor done it! He's going to go to next pay-per-view to be the Extreme Champion if he beats Gary or, of course, Happy Man. Pending who wins this I Quit match. It's still going on, people, as we speak. Over those leaving. Talk through the match replay, Tyler.
Well, I predicted that Teodor had the upper hand, and he did. And as you can see, those kendo shocks really added up. And that's what cost him the match there. Going for a big slam here. And then we have an elimination over on the left. Tiger did not disappoint. None of these wrestlers did.
Is this how Tiger get eliminated himself?
Sometimes your all is not good enough, so you gotta train harder and come back stronger.
Was I mistaken? It looked like Teodor was kind of holding his legs down, stopping the pin. You know, as he was holding it, Grasshopper hooked the legs. He was like holding them to stop him kicking out. So that was actually good teamwork.
Oh, a nice spear. That was a great spear.
Maybe if he had done that, Tiger would still be in it now. He might have won it.
He just smashed his neck region. Just too much to bear going on.
And Overlord, with that extra weight, he's over 500 pounds straight on top of him. It was just too quick. I think if Overlord in the match and Teodor had time to get to his feet and pin Grasshopper, it might allow Grasshopper enough time to kick out. But because Overlord, 500 pounds straight on his chest, he's literally going like, bang, my neck, to get pinned. There's nothing left in it. He just couldn't pull it off as we go into the next match, where of course is going to be Sir Dave taking on Grimhold. What's your thoughts on this? And talk us through their entrances, Tyler.
Well, this is going to be another great match, and this will go down in history and be remembered as one of the greatest, hopefully. because both of these wrestlers are definitely capable of making a true night of this pay-per-view. Stepping out here, we have Commissioner Sir Dave.
Definitely, I agree with that. But can Sir Dave overcome Grimhold? Oh, we're in the back again! This match is continuing! I almost knocked my glass over. Ow, my elbow! These two are going at it still! Look, the guy's just approaching him and he's just smashing him. Oh, he got the sharpshooter! He could quit right here and now! This could be it! Is he gonna quit? Is he tapping? I can't tell! Tyler, is he tapping?
He could be. No, he's not. He's holding on.
No, he got out of it! Happy Man can't believe it! And Gary's pushing them back. We have a body slam, a power slam even. While this goes on, Grimhold is making his entrance. Oh! He almost slammed him on the candlesticks. He's got him up from his behind. And he's giving him a drop. Oh, he punched him mid-air. And amazingly, Gary managed to turn that and land on his feet. Before he was swung viciously with some force into the Titantron item. That iron railing even. Oh, drop kick to Happy Man's face. That's going to make him very sad, man. Blow. To Gary from the Happy Man. And he goes for that whip again. And his left arm almost dislocated his shoulder, people, with the force of hitting that railing thing. He's got the kendo stick, and he slams him in the face with it. As the match is underway in the ring, as he goes for another kendo stick to the face. He's getting in for another sharpshooter. This could be it. Do you believe he's going to tap out now?
He could. He's definitely weakened down.
He's reaching for that kendo stick. And Sir Dave in that ring, amazing clothesline from top rope. Gary got out of it again. Gary got out of it. And he's getting to his feet. And Happy... Oh, we lost the feed. Happy Man, I get word in the back, he's apparently running. Again. And Gary's giving chase once more. What's your thoughts on that I Quit match and what's happening with it? What's still continuing now?
Well, I think it should have ended when they first started, but I guess they don't want to follow the rules and they're just looking to humiliate each other.
Definitely. Speaking of following the rules, Sir Dave's going high and Grimhold has a kendo. And Sir Dave completely missing. And before, oh, I thought he was going to get hit in his face. Do you see that? He just threw the kendo in the air after missing Sir Dave. And he's like, bring it. And Sir Dave did. He whipped him into that Chakotay railing. He has the kendo in both hands. His big stick is growing large as he gets caught with an RKO on the concrete. That came out of nowhere as he's punching him with all his life. He's basically punching him again as he spears him to the ground. He went for a clothesline. He missed. He's going for another punch. Like, his life depends on it. That's what I meant to say a minute ago. His life depends on it. Not punching with all his life. As he arm drags him on the concrete across his back of the kendo stick. And he whips him in the face with that kendo stick. So Dave's going in the ring. What's he doing? Oh, look at Grimhold just stepping in that ring. Oh, and he clotheslines him. He caught him off balance. Talk us through what's happening.
Well, it's a nasty brawl here with another clothesline just flattening him. Now he's going top rope.
Like a amazing soldier barge, wasn't it? As he goes high, and he hits a clothesline.
Ooh, a nice right hand. Another right hand, excuse me. But he's grabbing him here. He doesn't care about the punches.
What's Grimhold doing? He's shaking. Oh, I guess you would say, no, you're not going to win. That's what he must have been saying. No, no.
Up, dropping him on his head, brainbuster.
Oh, that ain't good. So Dave to his feet first. What's he doing? Going for it. Clothesline! First time we've seen that move this pay-per-view, and a few stars have decided to copy Striker from it. They're all using it now, it seems. He goes, hi. No, he's not. Did he catch him? Oh! He whipped him. What was he doing? Dropkick! He does the best dropkicks in the world! Perfection! Definitely. Oh, he's going outside. What's he going for? Maybe the kendo stick? I can see it here. Yeah, his little eyes have seen the kendo stick. He's coming out after him, Grimhold. I don't think that's smart on Grimhold's part. No, and he gets KO'd with that kendo stick. So Dave, what's he doing? So Dave's putting it all on the line here. Uh-oh, he's up! And he connects! His knees drove into the back of his head and forced his head into the railing. Not the railing, sorry. The The... Tyler, help me out. The...
The ramp?
The ramp! Yes, he rammed it up! He's got him by the hair. Grimhold's making a comeback. And he's power driving him on the ramp! Got it right in time. On the ramp, people! That's it, enough times, won't forget it. On the ramp, on the ramp! Ramp, ramp, ramp! Ramp, ramp, ramp!
One,
is he pinning him?
Two.
And he pinned him on the ramp!
Got a two count, it was almost over there.
On the ramp!
Uh-oh, he's picking up that weapon. Looking for fatal damage. And that's exactly what he's going
to
get.
To his back, why he's on the ramp!
You know what they say, the people that look for blood, they find it.
Definitely. And he falls on the ramp! He's going for a sharpshooter on the ramp!
Ooh.
And I can't see Grimhold tapping personally. On the ramp! Can you?
I can't, but anything's possible.
So Dave is given a beating. A real beating. He's wearing the big monster down. That is incredible. Oh, and he RKOs him. Wow. This night has been exhausting. Speaking of which, we're getting the feedback from Happy Man and Gary. Let's go to it now.
Oh, look at him cowering in front of me. You don't want me to hit you, do you? Well, it ain't gonna happen because I'm gonna hit you really hard right now. Oh, cheap shot.
Apparently, Happy Man was playing possum with him. He was like, leave me alone. And when Gary went to hit him, he cheap shot at him. So that match is still continuing. So tell me, we have two matches on the go. Where else do you see two matches on the go at the same time?
Nowhere but here.
That's why we're IWD. He's whipping him, he's punching him. And again, he's trying to lay the big man out. The punches wouldn't do it, but the kicks do.
Started taking his legs out. He's using his legs.
Yeah, I was going to say, the punches wouldn't work, but the feet would.
The explosion from the feet is what's really getting him down here.
I think Sir Dave's speed is winning this for him, and he has got strength. He's not as strong as Grimhold, but that speed and the strength he has is really paying off for him at the moment.
The last big man went down, so we could see the same thing.
Definitely, the commissioner is basically proving his point. And Grimhold keeps going on about again and again how people keep beating me by pinning other people in triple threats. They can't beat me one on one. So Dave's trying to prove him wrong. Oh, we're back in the back again. These two going at it still. As we get Kendall's in the ring. Kicks in the back. Oh, he caught him. What's Happy Man going to do in the back? Oh, he's punching him and again and again. And we have a submission in the ring. Maybe he'll quit. Oh no, power driver to Happy Man on the ramp! Wow! How is Happy Man continuing?
I have no idea here.
Oh, well, low blow, maybe because of that. Oh, Sir Dave made a mistake. Sir Dave, I think he slipped when he went for that lion salt.
His feet almost caught his head on the way down.
Yeah, basically the blood, I think there's a bit of blood earlier on the rope. We had so much blood tonight, his foot slipped.
Or maybe it's just a common mistake.
Might have been that too. But either way, that mistake is costing him. This could cost him the match. Don't give Grimhold opportunity, or else stuff like this happens. Oh!
Hit the mat and bounce back up.
That was vicious.
That's because he's throwing him down so hard. If you guys can't tell.
Yeah, this match is insane.
Picking him up, putting him straight in the air, and dropping him on his neck. Also, his brain. That's why we call it the Brain Buster.
Definitely. I just felt how many firsts tonight we had so far. We had the first ever cage match, Striker and Pitbull. We had the first ever I Quit match. What's still going on? We've had the first. We're soon going to have the first ever cage match with four people involved. We had the first ever six-man elimination match. I think this is the only regular match going for, isn't it? This match tonight.
Ooh, nice arm drag. Not good for
Sir Dave.
Sir Dave.
Grimhold is saying no, shaking his head again. Uh-oh, no, not the concrete.
Outside, no padding. Maybe it's a little.
I think
bit.
He got a bit of it, but that thing is thin. It's like paper. Don't really give him much cushion.
He got up, though, first.
That's impressive by Sir Dave.
Well, I mean, he is bigger, so his energy is going to be drained a lot faster. He's got a lot more weight to carry around.
I think he's running on adrenaline, though, because he knows if he slows down and Grimhold starts to really pump it out on him, he is going to be screwed.
He's saying no, no, no.
Oh.
Ooh, but he's saying yes, yes, yes.
Oh, and again.
Right hand and another right hand.
Oh, that wasn't smart. He was calling to the fans for something, and... Oh, the concrete! That was 100% the concrete.
Oh.
As you can see by the blood pouring out of his head and his veins. Yeah, he's still getting to his feet. I think he's a bit dazed. I think he's just going on like autopilot here. Gets up, just kicks him. He's going on autopilot. He's got to be. What is he? Spit of blood! Grab hold of this spit of blood, that last shot!
It's all those chest shots and all those face shots. He hit something and he screwed him up.
This could be the opening he needs. If he can basically go for this part now, really go for it while he's basically hurt, and get the pin quick. Oh no, I think he swallowed the blood, it stopped. This ain't good. Oh, he's hammering Sir Dave. Oh, he's hammering back. This is a slugfest now. Oh, I wouldn't go for a slugfest with Grimhold personally, but Sir Dave seems to be holding his own on the concrete. That was impressive. That was impressive. Oh my, he's going high. If he hits this, it could be over. If he misses it, it could be over. He hits it. Oh. Pin him, Sir Dave. Pin him, Sir Dave. He can pin him. I got him kicking out of this. Can you?
No.
Look at all that blood. Someone dragged a dead body. One. Two. Come on, Commissioner. Three. Sir Dave did it. Sir Dave won. Wahoo. What's your thoughts on that?
Well, it's very exciting. Like I said, another giant can fall, and that's exactly what happened here. We have little David going against the giant, and he didn't need a rock. He just used his hands as weapons.
Yeah, that amazing counter. And then he went high and risked it all, and it won it for him. He risked everything. Here it goes, this move, that counter. And you think pin him now, but he's like, no, he will kick out. I've got to end this. And it's all or nothing on this move. If he missed, it was over. If he hit, it was over. And he hit it, and it was over. And so Dave's hand was raised. Watch this, he pins him. And we see one, two, three, and that's all she wrote, people. All she wrote, people. That's IWD for you, right there. IWD for you. As we're going to go to the back in a minute and listen to the interviews of the main event stars, as the cameraman went a bit wonky there, as you see, for some reason. Of course, it's going to be Ivan Reaver versus Bryce the Best versus Crusher versus TJ Clip, the current IWD World Champion. Let's go to and listen to him now. Bryce, TJ Clip, doesn't matter who I'm in that ring with. Now it's a cage, so what? You think Striker's cage match was awesome? Wait till you see the one I'm in. And not only that, I'll be walking out as the World Champion. You know why? You know why? Because it's... What time is it? Listen, what time is it? I know what time it is. Do you know? I bet you do. It's Reaver time! That's what time it is. I think he's going on about Reaver time. The only Reaver time is the time that I will crush you and take you out for good and end your career. You're on about how you always have my number. Tonight it stops when I will walk away the IWD champion, crushing you in the process, breaking your neck, grabbing your eyeball, pulling it out, licking it and shoving it down my throat. As for Bryce the Best, well, your spine belongs to me, as I will snap it in two and wear it like a scarf for you, TJ Eclipse. You've got a very ugly nose. It offends me. I will pull it off. Stick it in your mouth. Smash it with your own teeth before pulling each and every tooth out and crunching them. Grabbing your toenails, fingernails, ripping them apart. So I will crush you all tonight. Bryce the Best, I'm in a world championship match with my older brother. I can't wait to compete against him for the second time in my career. The first time I came so close to beating you, TJ, and you knew it. You knew how close I was, but I was a rookie. I'm not a rookie now. I've got experience. I have taken on Crusher before as well. Crusher destroyed me and I lost, but the point is, I kept fighting. And I'm still here today to take you on again. I can take any beating you give me, Crusher. And as for Ivan Reaver, one of the best in the business. I admit it, completely awesome. But guess what? I'm faster than you. And you may be stronger, but again, I've got the speed advantage. And the fact is, I believe all three of you are going to underestimate me. And while you're destroying each other, I'll use my speed, my skill, and I'll surprise you. That's so well, so good, that I'll be out of that cage. That's right, a cage match, and I will be the new IWD World Champion. Because why? Because I'm Bryce the Best. That's why.
This match tonight has many great wrestlers in it. But there's one that stands out more than any other one in that locker room. Me, TJ Eclipse, your world champion. That's not going to change. I've gone through hell and back to keep this around my waist, and I will not slip up tonight. I've come too far to give it all away now. I can be a good guy, and I can be a bad guy. But at the end of the night, I do what has to be done to win and to remain the star of the show, the world champion, TJ Eclipse.
Wow, we get the entrances. That's some interesting words from all four competitors there. TJ didn't really talk about his opponents, more about himself. Well, he does have big ego, so that's not surprising. Crusher was on about breaking people's spines, pulling noses off, you know, ripping fingernails, toenails off and stuff? What was that about?
I don't know, he's a psychopath and obviously a cannibal.
Yeah, and eating eyeballs. Ivan was out there basically, you know, it's Reaver time. He's finally going to be the IWD champ. And Bryce was saying everyone's going to underestimate him, and that's why he's going to use his speed to get out the cage and be crowned IWD champion. What's your thoughts on what they both had to say?
Well, as you've seen earlier in the night, the steel cage match is very dangerous, and absolutely anything can happen. You can be at the very top and get shaken down and fall right on your neck.
Oh, we're in the back again. Graham Hall just caught Gary. What the fudge? What's going on? Oh, what? This doesn't look good. What's he doing? What's he setting up for? Holy wantless, what's his move? Oh my god!
Oh! My god!
And we lost the feed, people!
He threw him up and caught him for a slam.
That was like some kind of vicious super powerball!
Something you see in a movie.
Yeah, I don't think Gary's moving after that. This would be perfect for Happy Man to come in. But if he's unconscious, how could you give up even conscious? Wow. Why did Grim Hold attack Gary?
I have no idea, but I'm guessing it's for a reason he thought was justified.
Maybe he was annoyed after losing Sir Dave, and Gary's in the wrong place, wrong time. After all, he is in the back running around after Happy Man. He happens to run into Grimhold. Because obviously Grimhold lost his match, and you know, he was so, people can't beat me one-on-one. You have to beat weaklings, and then he got pinned. So I think he's very annoyed. Speaking of which, Russia's about to come out, who is good friends with Grimhold. What do you think this guy's chances in this match are?
Well, he's a bear. Well, he's a very big guy.
He's a berry.
He's a big blueberry. He's a very strange and odd wrestler, but I guess he does get the job done. You guys look at the rivalry between him and Bryce, things were heated up, and Bryce got crushed, as his name says.
And of course, him and Ivan had a big rivalry, and Ivan got him fired, and Ivan seems to have his number up until this point, but will that happen tonight? Or will Crusher... Basically, like the Striker Pitbull thing. Pitbull had Pitbull had Striker's number all the way up until tonight and still had his number. Ivan's had Crusher's number all the way to tonight. But will Crusher turn it around, what Striker couldn't do earlier? Hopefully that makes sense at that point.
Better second time around.
Yeah, definitely. As here comes our current IWD World Champion. Not only that, he's a two-time, the only two-time World Champion we've had. And as I said earlier, a little fact, this match, him and Ivan will now be tying for pay-per-view main events with Gary for the most competed in. Well, I think it's impressive. Up to this point, Gary has had the most pay-per-view main events. Well, him and Ivan will tie after this match. So they're the three people with the most. I believe, isn't this Crush's first pay-per-view main event of his career? To get himself on that little scoreboard, so to speak?
I believe so.
And I believe it's also Bryce's too. So we only have one guy in there who's current world champion and no former champs at all. Ivan's yet to have a belt, Crush it is, and so is Bryce. So everyone, as the match is underway, everyone's got so much to go for. Oh, he's going high. Ivan straight away. What's he doing? Oh! That's like a moonsault clothesline. That was impressive. He's whipping him. Oh, we're going to the back. Oh, he's in submission. It must be after Grimhold got him.
Uh-oh. It looks like he's going to tap.
He tapped! Happy Man keeps the belt. The camera cut straight away. What was that about? Why did the camera suddenly cut?
No idea.
So, Happy Man's to the stream champion. What's your thoughts on that situation?
Pay attention, everybody. 1 minute. World champ's going up top.
Oh, no! Oh! That could be him out of the match. That could be his belt gone. Right there and then if he can't get up from that. As I say that, he gets to his feet. Oh, Crush is going for some now, is he? Everyone's trying to stop him. Look at this. Look at Crusher fly. Oh. Look at Iron fly. Oh, he got TJ from behind. No one standing is Bryce. Crusher's back to his feet. The monster's back to his feet. This ain't good. And TJ's going straight for him. Oh, he's got him. What's in the? Oh, we just saw an arm drag and a brain buster. Pretty and unique. Oh, Crusher's going straight for Bryce, I believe. As we go to the back to listen to the commissioner, Sir Dave. Okay, Sir Dave is here. I've just been informed by some people in the back that when Gary tapped out, it wasn't actually Gary. Apparently, Grimhold walloped Gary and was battling him while Happy Man was editing a past video with his sharpshooter on him and added Gary tapping out sound effects. I don't know if that's correct or not, but for now, I guess Happy Man won the match, but I am going to look into this. And if I do find out he has cheated, there will be consequences on next Chronic Pain. Now join the main event, people. Respect that.
Wow! Do you hear that? Happy Man cheated! Edited a video while Grimhold was taking care of Gary. Is he going to look into this to find out if that's true or not?
We don't know if it's true. We're going to need evidence from the commissioner first.
Oh, Crusher could win. He's climbing high. As Ivan goes high too. Oh, TDA's going high too. Look at this. Moonsault. Oh! As Bryce took him both down. Ivan doesn't see Bryce. Oh, no. Now he does. I don't think Bryce realised Ivan's looking at him. Uh-oh. This ain't good. Ivan's, like, waiting. Oh, look at that move. Look at that spin. Almost a 360 to Bryce. Almost a 360. That was incredible. He's whipping Ivan now, TJ is. Who would you give this match to? That's what we see in RKO.
Well, I'd have to say TJ Eclipse so far. Taking some really bad falls, but that doesn't mean anything, as you see.
Was Ivan doing? Oh, Lion Soul clothesline. That's amazing. It's like a, you know, upside down clothesline the way he does that. He whips him and he gets the extra run and the momentum as he's coming back at him. As we see a power driver to Bryce. As Crush is trying to destroy him, and Ivan's taking to TJ. Oh, what's Ivan doing? Oh, he's saying bring it. No, is Ivan? Oh, is Ivan trying to sneak one? No, no, no. Crush saw him, and TJ's back to his feet. I think Ivan was trying to sneak out then, but he realised he wasn't going to get far. Oh, brainbuster! Oh, is he going for it again? No, high. He's going high. Oh, he's pinning him. One, two. Oh, I think TJ just saved his championship. Do you agree?
Yeah, I mean, it was a two count. One more count, he would have been the new world champ.
That would have been Bryce. Oh, Ivan! Oh, no! Oh! How are these guys getting up from this? That's if Ivan can get up from it. The way his arm might be broke. See if he's carrying on. Ivan's back to his feet. Ivan got up somehow. Oh, he's got TJ from behind. And again. And again, give him a bit of humpy here, apparently. What are you doing? Takes him down. Apparently, he kept grabbing him from behind, and TJ kept pulling him apart. Okay, he's looking in his face, and he drop kicks him. I was going to say every man's down, but as I was about to fall into my sentence, Crush got to his feet. Kicks after kick after kick, stomping mud holes inside, none other than Bryce, who believes he's the best. Will he prove it tonight? Will he be the best and prove it tonight as Ivan takes Crusher down from behind? Okay, they're all on the feet again, and TJ saying no more as he whips Ivan. And he RKOs him! Wow, all four guys down. What's your thoughts? What's going on?
What a terrific move to take all his opponents down. Now they're all starting to wake up a little bit.
Do you believe that TJ's got this in the bag, or is this favoring Crusher now, favoring Ivan or Bryce?
Well, excuse me. I think that TJ still has a good chance. He just got to get to his feet before something bad happens to him.
Yeah, because the thing is, as we know, he can be pinned in submission. Like, now Bryce going for a pin. Like, if Ivan wasn't there, would that have been over right there and then, before TJ got to his feet? He could lose the belt as Ivan's going for a pin, and TJ breaks it up. He could lose the belt with not even involved in the pin. He could be basically pinning someone and someone reaches both feet hit the floor first before the freak out and he wins. Or loses in this case if that happens to him. RKO people. He's got Crush's got Ivan and he's trying to rip his neck off with that dragon sleeper. And Bryce broke it up straight away. And he's like, did you see that? Oh! I was gonna say, Bryce was golding. Crush is saying, hit me, and out of nowhere, Ivan low blowed the pair of them!
Oh, Bryce is bleeding now.
That is not good for Bryce. Bryce is now in trouble. Oh, what a move. What a move. Oh, and Ivan's getting straight up from it. That's incredible. Didn't TJ just hit him with that move, and Ivan got to his feet first. Oh, Ivan's going to climb. Is he going to win it? Ivan can do it!
No, maybe he can.
Uh-oh, Crush is getting a really good big run up here. Oh my! Holy fudge! He's dead! He's killed and he's dead! He's dead!
This is Bryce's opportunity.
Look at the way Ivan slunched over! I think he's dead!
TJ Eclipse can win. They're staring each other down.
What are they doing? They're doing harmony! Why did they both hit at the same time?
They're both climbing up.
Ivan's up though. I think Ivan's getting ready for a run up. Is he? No? Yes, he is. Oh, both brothers go down! Whoa!
TJ Eclipse bouncing to the bars.
And Crush is taking him down, and Ivan's using the opportunity to sneak out. This could be it. If he doesn't stop him, Ivan's won. Whoa!
Oh.
Ah! Crush is pinning Bryce! One, two, three! You world champ, Crusher! And he didn't pin TJ, who gets up to stare him down! He didn't pin Ivan, he didn't pin TJ. He pinned Bryce. What?
Petijay?
Yeah, that's it. TJ. TJ Tyler clips. TJ clips. That's incredible. What's what we just saw? Replays go through.
Well, that was an amazing match. And as you can see there, there's more than one way to win. Crusher took the advantage there.
And look, he's looking at them and Ivan tried to sneak out and got caught. But what do you think? TJ lost his title, but he was not pinned. Ivan also was not pinned. It was the guy everyone thought was the weak link of the match.
He's not going to be happy with his brother.
Three.
Nope, definitely. Technically, Bryce, as you just said, his brother cost him his match, his championship. And look at him get straight up. And look, he's just staring down at Bryce. He's not even looking at Crusher. Did you see that? Wow. Well, anyway, this is IVATOPIA saying bye, everybody, with
Tyler Steele.
Saying bye. Like, subscribe, that good stuff, and tune in next time on Chronic Pain. Last pay-per-view, this is of the year. Can't wait for the shows going on. And I keep talking. Bye.